esportsbets.com, a unique place for true gamers. The only place to bet on esports events. You know your way around a competitive gaming scene and are willing to take a risk? Watch regular broadcasts and earn real money. esportsbets.com. Foresight, passion, and calculation.
All right, and with that, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back here to the second map, which is not quite starting off, but I couldn't wait any longer. I was too excited about all this crazy action that we've already seen on the first map. Overtime, first map of the Grand Finals. You know something has gone right then. And before we get into the second map, we want to do this subscriber giveaway that we've been promising. So we're going to wait a little bit with the Cyrix. That's going to be later, guys. So stick around if you want to win that. But for now, we're going to do this StatTrek AK-47 blue laminate. So if you want to win it, then start typing raffle in the chat. And then, you know, later you can try and see if you can win some more. But we'll start off with that one. And I will open the raffle right now. So raffle away, guys. And again, a big thanks to all of our subs for helping us out with the channel. It does make a big difference in our ability to run it on a weekly and daily basis. But what a crazy game! I don't know, Semlo, are you back yet?
Yep, that was. I'm just digesting it right now, like what we just witnessed, because that was really just something special. Like, it's not every day you see a team nearly clean sweep another team in a grand finals of a LAN event. Like, that just does not happen very often, ladies and gentlemen. If you're just tuning in, this is CS at its finest, the most exciting that Fnatic actually managed to do that. I'm still blown away.
Yeah, and they could just as well have won it, right? I mean, it was down to the barest of margins. Very, very close game overall. And I did just really beautiful Counter-Strike. I mean, if you're new to the game, if you're just joining the Counter-Strike scene and you're wondering, you know, what can I expect, then, you know, at the top level, this is what it's like and why it's so much fun.
Exactly. That's why we can't get enough, man. We can't get enough.
Need more Counter-Strike. We've only got 3 people on the server, so we have a little bit of time to do the raffle, so I'm just going to leave it running for a little bit later, guys, after this one. I think after this map. So, yeah, let's say after this next map, we're going to give away the Cyrix that was given to us by Stony, who's just, I don't know, a very generous person. He's given us a ton of stuff already, so we're going to have to figure out a way to thank him, basically. But, yeah. This one first, later for the Cyrix, and earlier today we also gave away a Deagle. So we try and make it like a regular thing on the channel that we give stuff away. Normally we preserve it for our Case King of the Hill day, which is on Tuesday this time around. But, you know, because it's Star Series and it's finals and all the rest, we wanted to step it up a little bit and see if we could do that. So I'm going to leave the raffle open for another 10 seconds, guys, and then we're going to close it and draw a winner. But, I mean, Inferno, I would say if any map, this is the map that I would say Fnatic. I would feel very comfortable about Fnatic winning on this map, to be honest.
Yes, I would too, actually. This is the thing. Why I'm going to come back to the point I was making towards the end of regular time, when Fnatic were still floating around 10, 11 rounds, is the fact that, as far as Fnatic were concerned, you know, it's the never give up, never surrender mindset, but they're already thinking, like, okay, well, now we see, with NaVi on, like, one round away from securing the map, it's astronomical odds that we actually run it back. So we get as many rounds in and we play as hard as we can to get, you know, to get in the flow, basically, get in the zone going into the rest of this series. Because a best of five is a long time. One map does not decide at all until you get down to the end, right? So you're still thinking, you know, how it's all going to pan out. Yeah. So Fnatic getting that many rounds on the board, making it that close. Sure, NaVi win it, but NaVi have got to be shaken. They've got to be like, well, they took 15 rounds in a row versus us before we could actually close out that map. What the hell? Whereas Fnatic are like, sweet, okay, now we're warmed up, we're ready to go. Inferno's going to be brutal.
Yeah, that definitely does put you on notice. I agree. That's a scary thing to even consider. But it shows you that what Fnatic are all about. So I'm happy they managed to do it. Now, guys, the raffle is closed, and I'm going to draw the winner right here, right now. It is Muppet Nick, who has typed something in the chat, Muppet Nick, and I'll see if I can find you. So a lot of spam going on, so do it maybe a couple of times. You shouldn't be affected by the slow time, so just make sure I can try and find your nickname. That's the AK that you've won, so just need some sort of visual confirmation. I'm trying horribly to catch your name. And then later we're going to do the Cyrix as well, guys, so there will be a chance for you to win that if you didn't win this time around. Muppet Nick.
Muppet Nick. I like that name. It's almost as good as Bill Nye.
Yeah, well, yeah, Bill Nye was a really good nick. I like that, especially backwards, just very confusing. So, still ready and waiting. Seen anyone? Has anyone seen Muppet Nick yet?
Has I haven't seen Muppet Nick, but shouldn't it be picked up in the software? Like, if he types in the chat, it confirms?
It might be. I'm still just ready and waiting. Haven't seen anyone just yet.
Where is this Muppet?
Yeah, well, we got a little bit of time to find him. We've got 9 people on, so we're not that pressed for time, but obviously eventually we'll have to either redraw or try and do it again later. Muppet Nick, if you're out there, then type something in the chat. Otherwise, we will have to... Oh, there he is! Did I win? Yes, you did, sir! And you managed to show up just in the last second, so good job. I hate redrawing. That's always a little bit disappointing doing that, so I'm just gonna do this, and then I'm gonna write you a message, and I'll get you the details later for how you do it, so just so we can be clear. So I'll get to you later, Nick, and we'll figure it out. And remember, we do have the other giveaway as well as Fire Cyrex. Later on, we're going to give this away to another lucky subscriber. But now, Semler, we need to focus on this game because, I mean, right now the map score is 1-1. Fnatic had a 1-map lead going into the Grand Finals, coming from the upper bracket, and NaVi, they took the first map that was technically played on Mirage. So, I mean, this could go to all 4 maps. We still have... train after this, and then for the final map, if it goes to it, it's gonna be either Dust 2 or Nuke, based on a coin flip. And that's a coin flip that has some value for NaVi.
Oh yes, it does. And it can't we can't possibly have a repeat of Gamescom. Like, if it ends up coin flipping to Nuke, I think all of us, it's just gonna be like 55,000 people flipping tables everywhere across the world, pretty much. Yeah, that's just ridiculous. For it to happen at Gamescom, for it to have already happened in the past to NaVi in a finals like this, for it to have gone down to the wire and for them to have lost on Nuke, and then to go to Gamescom and have their best of 3 in the quarterfinals randomly select Nuke as the final deciding map, and for it to go to that map, and then for them to lose on it versus Fnatic. If NaVi, if it coin flips onto Nuke again, I think they flip over the table on the stage and walk out.
Well, it's happened at Gamescom, but it certainly also happened at one of the previous Star Series. NaVi were in the exact same position. I think they played NIP back then.
Yes.
And ended up losing because, you know, it went to Nuke, which, and this is just for anyone who doesn't know, NaVi just don't play Nuke. They never have, like, all the way going back through the 1.6 history as a team that came out and just for a while crushed every single other team on LAN, but never on Nuke. That was just not their style, and they never have picked it up since, so that coin flip, if it goes to it, is going to be pretty important.
Well, for them, the reasoning behind it, and it's also the reasoning why, like, Fnatic, they kind of put some time into Nuke, but they don't fully commit to it, is because there are teams that have just thousands of hours of experience on the map, and NaVi feel like it's such a huge mountain that they'd have to climb to become competitive on the map that they'd much rather focus on the new maps, for example, Overpass and Cobblestone, and just get really good at Overpass and Cobblestone because everybody's going to be pragging those maps and everybody's starting at the same time, whereas on Nuke, they would just have a massive, massive amount of information that they'd have to absorb that all the other teams in the scene are just, they already have that.
That kind of makes sense on some level to me. I just still feel like there's something. I mean, I guess this is really one of the only times. It's not that often that maps are decided on coin flips, but now because the last major did have that random function, maybe it's time for NaVi to. They don't even have to become the best at it. They just have to become like, you know, they just have to be able to play the map on some level, right?
Well, at that point, they you know, if they have an extra month, they practice Cobblestone and Overpass.
Yeah.
And then it's not a problem. They leave Cobblestone and Overpass and they just veto Nuke. But they decided to take the risk. Again, you know, it's like random. You know, they get to any of the other maps, they have a real match versus Fnatic. And it lands, of course, on the one map that they're all trying to avoid. So it's silly in the end, but that's what it comes down to. NaVi have to live with that because they still made the decision to leave that map in the pool when they could have used one of their vetoes on it.
Well, we do have the knife round. If you're just joining us, then welcome to Room on Fire. This is the SLTV Star Series Season 10 Grand Finals between NaVi and Fnatic. And we're on the second map here, NaVi having already won on Mirage, but Fnatic with a one map lead means technically the map score is 1-1. So big welcome to the show here, and this is going to be on Inferno for a, well, it's a best of five grand finals. Next map is going to be Train, and we actually know already, no matter what, we will see Train, which is great news. The only way someone can prevent Dust2 or Nuke right now is by winning this map and the next one. If it goes, to, you know, one map for either team, then we're going to go to the fifth map, and that will be fun.
That would be madness. Oh, I'm really excited, though. This is going to be perfect. Inferno is going to be a very clear picture of where these teams stand as well, because both of them are very good on Mirage. NaVi, they win it in the end, and we kind of see NaVi as one of the best teams in the world on Mirage right now. Definitely top three, up there with VP. Hell, even Dignitas I'd put up in that same kind of stratosphere, right? But Inferno, Fnatic have been playing impeccably on it, and NaVi have been kind of struggling. Like, not clean sweeps versus HR. Definitely had to put up fights. So Fnatic, I think, have a bit of an edge once again, but we said that on Mirage, and look what happened. Now are Fnatic going to be able to get a strong start here on Inferno and live up to the hype?
I mean, I think they're going to be frustrated that they didn't end up winning once they made that sick comeback and forced overtime, which was truly incredible. I mean, even if they didn't win it, that's still absolutely sick from Fnatic. But at the same time, if you consider that they could have lost that first map 16-2, basically, I actually think now that they've had a break and they can take a step back, I think they're going to be able to say, look, guys, we proved that we can do this. Now we're on a map that we're heavily favored on. Let's show these CIS people how Inferno's played, right?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, I mean, again, all of those rounds, achieving one of the sickest comebacks we've seen for a long time. But, you know, getting all those rounds on the board has only just warmed up Fnatic. So they're going to be fully ready to go here on Inferno. NaVi are going to be, again, the ones who have to hold them off. But NaVi get to pick exactly which side they start on. And again, they start on the CT side. So they will get a stronger start to this map. They will play the favored side on this map. And Fnatic are going to be the ones who have to come up with the tricky strategies. But then again, we're talking about Fnatic. We've already got like two smoke strats that we call Fnatic on Inferno. So I think I'm really going to be interested in seeing what exactly Pronax has in store for us here on this map in particular, because he seems to love it.
Yeah, we've been seeing a couple of different sort of iterations of NaVi. My voice almost dying. That's scary. A couple of different iterations of, I think, the B defense especially is the interesting one for NaVi on this map, where sometimes they seem to leave Starix very much alone over here, and sometimes it works out absolutely great, and sometimes it doesn't. So I don't know what NaVi are going to do this time around, but I feel like that B defense is going to be a critical point, because Fnatic last time they played were pretty good at zoning in on that B bomb side and realizing that was the weak point.
Following a little bit here, what's going on? Imagine they're all just doing the huddle right now, getting pumped up for this map. Everything, I mean, it's really riding on this. But you're right, they have faced on this map before in the winter bracket final, and Fnatic really did identify exactly where NaVi were weak on the map, and this only took Pronax, what, like 6-7 rounds to figure out, and then it turned into just the wild rumpus going towards B every round, Fnatic just rolling right through. So are NaVi going to be able to make the adjustments necessary to hold off Fnatic? Zeus and Starix we didn't see too much of in Mirage. You know, they weren't topping the frag list, they weren't really like stepping in too much, but on Inferno, Starix was going big versus Hellraisers on B site. So I think it's going to be a different beast of Starix, basically a different brand of Starix that we're going to get to see here versus Fnatic right now in the grand finals.
I mean,
and he was definitely on the first day in the winner bracket match. He was definitely not quite there for NaVi when they needed him versus Fnatic. So we'll see if he can make up for it this time.
Yeah, and it's been kind of all over the place for NaVi throughout this finals. It's been, you know, some really, you know, A game type of NaVi where they've just been playing really well and everyone's been stepping it up. But it's actually Edward and Seized, I think, doing the majority of the fracking on Mirage. And then we've seen the other slightly confused and uncoordinated NaVi. And that kind of NaVi can't show up right here. I think even if NaVi play their very best on Inferno, it's still going to be one hell of a tough match.
Well, I think the real question is going to be, does Guardian show up? Is the G-Rex unleashed? As we saw, like he played a big part for NaVi going throughout this entire tournament, really, you know, top fragging most of the time for NaVi, and with a sick ratio as well. So is Guardian going to be able to A, get up to that AWP fairly quickly here on their CT side, and also be able to put it to use the way he needs to be able to do here versus Fnatic? a lot is riding on, I think, Guardian's performance to get the ball rolling for Na'Vi. And there's a lot of pressure on him, but he's certainly capable of delivering when it comes down to it. I think we're right now, we're just kind of waiting on Fnatic to get ready to get into this, because Na'Vi, they're running all over the place. Everybody's ready on their side.
Yeah, Fnatic, 1 second is what they're saying, so we should be going live just about now. Oh, man. I'm so happy that Na'Vi managed to take the first map, if for no other reason than just the fact that that means we're going to see more maps. Would have been a little bit sad if Fnatic had taken two in a row and had finished the grand finals like that, right? But that's no longer an option, so now we get to go maybe the full distance. At least more than halfway.
Yeah, now we go the distance, right? But we are about to be live here with our first map. Our first map when the teams are 1-1, we'll put it that way, right? But Inferno, between Na'Vi and Fnatic. Star Series 10, room on fire. Anders, Semler, ready to go. Let's do it, Anders!
I am feeling ready, and of course Vendetta, who's normally here with us, would have been here as well, but he's got some business to take care of, and if he gets sorted out by the time we're still live, he's going to come back and join us. But obviously, wanted to let him do that. He's been casting all day anyway, so maybe it's good for him to get a bit of breathing time as well. I was having a bit of time off earlier today. Game is not live. They had some sort of issues. They're going to be restarting once again. Man, what's the... I mean, we're up at 197,213 followers now. I think that's what my screen says anyway. So keep following the channel, guys. If you haven't already clicked the follow button, then help us out, and we'll definitely appreciate it. Let's get it on. I think now we're finally live, and now we get to start on the CT side. It will be Fnatic on the Terrorist side.
Yes, we are live now. Looking at it, we have... Not a whole lot of nades actually picked up for Na'Vi here. They're expecting the long drawn out fight. Four Kevlars and a kit on Zeus. Whereas Fnatic, two of these guys have gone full nades, and only three Kevlars. Flusha pushed up the top banana, and Pronex, two kills quick, very early on here already. Both sides of the map, but Guardian is still holding solid here on the B site, slowing down this push by Fnatic.
Yeah, but they're gonna rotate back to A here, and this is where Fnatic are really good at making the right calls. They realize there's going to be nobody at A, except for Seuss, but he's kind of alone, and he has to take down JW. He's actually going to try and fall back here. Can he get caught in the meantime? It seems like it's too late, Semler.
It is, and now look at JW's position. He's going to catch Guardian, trying to rotate around from B, pre-fire around the corner, gets the headshot, and it's going to be all down to C's now. 1v4, 3 points of health, waiting in library, but not too much hope going into this right now, because the bomb is planted and Fnatic, they're set up to catch him wherever he comes from. Sees this, I don't know what he's waiting for. Maybe he's just waiting to see if he can't get a knife in somewhere.
It's an interesting choice, especially with 3 points of health, but
that would be sick if he could.
That would have been a nice amount of money. Not going to happen. He will save the body armor, so he's going to be able to use that the next round. I wouldn't be surprised if Na'Vi, especially on Inferno, the C-set 75 armor buy is just so strong. So actually, Fnatic, who have been, I think, pretty good at handling their anti-ecos, they got to make sure they really get this round home.
And Guardian even spending every dime he's got. That's really interesting. Guardian going for the Deagle Kevlar helmet play. Seized only investing in a CZ-75, not going for helmet armor, so interesting enough there. But Fnatic don't usually mess around with this too much. JW and Pronex are the two guys going with just straight CZs. Only three rifles picked up on Fnatic here, and they're about to walk into a B-stack. This is perfect for Na'Vi.
Yeah, they're going to drop two. Actually, take a while before they take down JW here. Seized jumping back, but he's going to re-peek and will get downed by Flusher. But this is still a 3-on-3. And right now, it's Fnatic that are on notice. I mean, Na'Vi have already done a fair bit. And they're going to leave Starix here. He's got 22 bullets.
Yeah, Starix is fine right now. It's Guardian taking a peek down mid, and he's going to find Olafmeister. Managed to tag him once. Olaf alive with the AK. But this is still all three rifles alive for Fnatic still, and they're going to be pushing up to this B site, but they leave the bomb behind. And now Na'Vi have already closed in behind them. Guardian trying to catch him out, and he will gun flush her down. Edward there to lend a hand, and they both get caught. Krim saving the day, but Fnatic leaving the bomb behind. That was a very weird call there. That can't be involuntary.
No, that was definitely a sort of a situation where everyone thought that one of the other two people was going to pick it up. That could have cost them the round. Right now, I think they're still in a great position to win it here. Starix, he's close enough, but not going to be good enough here. Crims will take the triple, and Fnatic are going to secure the round. But that was very, very scary. And if Guardian hadn't been reloading his deal when they came for him, then yes, a good chance that could have been a 2-on-1 instead. in favor of Na'Vi.
Yeah, Edward getting caught out as well with the CZ, getting caught out in the open, basically, so... Like, if Edward stays alive behind a pillar, if anything happens there, Fnatic, life gets very difficult for them very quickly, so... Bit of a missed opportunity there for Na'Vi. Fnatic, they can breathe a sigh of relief, and again, it's only JW and Pronex... Only sticking with pistols, only three rifles again for Flesh of Crimson Wolfmeister, but look at how they're using these pistols. It's basically Fnatic charging up to the B site with these two guys to get scouting information, not risking a rifle.
Yeah, it's a four-man stack going on right here, and this is a big risk for Fnatic. I'm not really sure I'm enjoying this. I know certainly Vendetta would be pretty angry at this point, and Edward is boosted up into that cheeky spot here. Did he boost himself up? I think he might have actually done that. Can you do that? Did he jump over and then crouch in? Either way, Pronex is going to open it up, and Guardian trying to get a kill. They will take down Pronex, and the A-bomb site's lost. In the meantime, Seized was over there with a Mag 7, but he couldn't pick up the kill.
Yeah, and JW's already got that Mag 7 on his side. He's like, okay, sweet, yoink. He can definitely put that gun to work. We've seen him do it in the past. $900 per shotgun kill as well is a lot of money, and JW is a terror with that weapon. So it's going to come down to Edward now alive. Last man here for Na'Vi in this third round, but 1v4, P250, and already kind of floating around, not really committing anywhere, looking to see if he can catch somebody off guard from Fnatic. It would be great if he could pick up another kill here and make sure that Fnatic are spending some money, but Pronex and JW saved so much money throughout these rounds. It's been very interesting how Fnatic have been approaching this.
Yeah, it really is, and I mean, they almost lost the round because of it. This time it works out much better, though, so that's good news, and in the upcoming round, they are going to have a decent amount. Pronex the only one dying, so he's going to be able to rebuy, and the rest have actually a pretty good bank. So I think in the grand scheme of things, Fnatic have done a fine job in the first three rounds here, and Na'Vi now can finally buy, and they're going to use pretty much all their money, because they've actually bought in almost all the rounds, so they're not going to have that much. I mean, the smokes are really important. They're going to have five smokes, which is kind of crucial, but for everything else, they're going to be kind of low.
Yeah, no kit picked up either. They decide to invest in helmet armor over someone actually picking a kit, so it's going to come down to Na'Vi just stopping this plan from happening in the first place, or if it does happen, just shutting it down immediately. JW manages to sneak his way into Boiler, but Zeus has spotted it, so Na'Vi are aware. They know that there's a guy in there, and Edward is holding fairly aggressively on the angle as well. Well, smoke is down. Edward not really taking too much damage, but there you go. Olafmeister with the spray. Edward returns and drops Olaf down to 16. He loses that exchange, but Zeus is still alive here watching Boiler, and JW, it's going to be Krims taking the peek, in fact, but nothing really coming of it apart from Zeus spotting it and getting information.
Yeah, he didn't want to re-peek, which might be a smart idea right now. Now we don't want to lose the entry frag. Starix is over here, and they're going to flash their way through the smoke. Nice play, but they can't catch Starix, and he's going to fall back and smoke up with 50 seconds left. It's not a bad smoke timing to hit here. Can he defend? Flashbangs rain through. Starix, M4 in hand, still 21 bullets. He's going to hold down Mouse 1, and it works. Not at all. JW will take him down, and now Seized is going to be rotating around. He's going to get zoned out as well. And look at this position from JW.
Now this is the big surprise position, and it's going to work perfectly. Catches Guardian rotating in. He's going to look for Seized as well. Finds him. Two kills for JW now. Eviscerating the defense. Na'Vi, it's down to Edward and Zeus, and they know that there are four members alive here for Fnatic. That's kind of been the theme so far on Inferno, but Fnatic are about to pick up their fourth round, and there isn't a whole lot that Na'Vi can do about this. Na'Vi really need to hold on to these guns at this point. You can tell in their play, they're just as far away from Fnatic as they can possibly get. They need to hold on to these rifles so that in the next round, if they have the money, they can force up.
Yeah, I mean, Zeus chickening out of the round, literally on the chicken house. It's like some sort of weird effect going on there. And Edward's going to be able to survive as well. So they will save the two rifles. The rest, I don't think, should be buying up, to be honest. I think it's better for Na'Vi to save. And even though it's not... Or they will actually force up anyway. So that's very interesting. I think that's... I don't know. That's a big risk to run here. Because, look, they have one smoke and one Molotov here. How on earth are they going to hold a bomb site?
I'm asking myself the same question right now. They have to come out ahead if they decide to take the early aggression here. Seized is going to manage to pick up one frag and gets out in one piece as well, down to 40 HP, but still, great start here for Na'Vi. And it's plays like that that are going to make the difference. They don't have many nades, and they've already used the smoke and the molly, so they have three flashes on their side, Na'Vi, to hold off the Fnatic push when it comes through.
Flusher's going to flash in, and they're actually just going to grenade their way into this bomb site. One grenade, a little bit of an HE, and then now comes the smokes and everything else. Starix and Seized are in here, and they actually don't, they can counter flash once, and that's just gonna buy a, you know, a second basically. It won't even hit anyone here. Starix trying to gun through the smoke, but Fnatic have already made their way through, and they're gonna run right into Guardian here, and he's gonna go down. This is working out so well for the Swedes.
Oh, it really is. Starix gets overwhelmed instantly as well. Too many angles to watch from him, essentially. Had to watch towards Flowers, towards CT, towards Banana. He was gonna get caught out no matter what happened. So Starix, not long for it. NaVi about to lose a fifth round here as Zeus and Edward once again have to back off and save the guns. And this is just going to keep happening here for NaVi. If they can keep two guys alive, they can keep forcing up. But I really, like, this is the fine line that NaVi are going to start walking at this point, is how far do they push it? How far are they willing to basically give Fnatic? Like, how many rounds are they willing to give Fnatic here? Because every time they force up, it's an easier job for Fnatic. But if they are willing to say, okay, we give Fnatic one more round, we go for an eco, but then in that following round, we shut them down because Guardian has an AWP, we have full nades, we have full kits, we have everything. We have to see, and again, they go for the force. Yeah. So I don't know, I feel like NaVi, they could afford to give a round here to Fnatic to, in order to get a full buy.
But they are not going to do it, they're going to force it up once again. I mean, if they have the round loss bonus, I guess they're going to go for it. This has been a really tough first half for these fish over in the bomb site, and I'm sort of wondering if they're defending those ammo boxes or if they're really defending the fish. That we don't know the storyline entirely for Inferno, but Fnatic don't care. They're going to go for the kills, top of Banana, and it's going to be a quick exchange, and Crims will come in with another one, leaving Seuss inside the bomb site. Another great start for Fnatic. They are really out for revenge after what happened on Mirage.
Yeah, that they are. I mean, really, like, they are not. This is the warmed up Fnatic now, basically. This is how Mirage was supposed to go for Fnatic early on. And now Fnatic are just rolling right on through. There's only Zeus alive. He has zero nades to help. Edward is gonna, or Guardian rather, has rotated over, but again, no nades on Guardian either. It's just to Edward. He hears Ulfmeister going by, and he's gonna get a freebie there, but Crims has taken out Zeus on that B side. In the meantime, Flusha sprays through the smoke, just Flusha things, takes out Guardian, and this is now a 1v3 situation. Edward not going to be able to get over here in time to be able to do anything about it either. Although Pronex, oh, I love this. Now, is Pronex really delaying the plants to give time for his teammates to rotate over and go hunting? Because they know Edward isn't here.
Yeah, it's not a bad idea if that's what they did. Certainly, Flush is very close right now. I actually think Seuss inside the bombsite should have got the first kill on the guy that was coming out of yellow. That was a big misplay, in fact. He had the angle for it, and they were looking the wrong way. That could have been an opening into NaVi coming back in the round. Now instead, Edward's going to go down. Fnatic seem to be playing just way too well at the moment. 7-0-1 on Crims. JW at 7-2-3.
And here is the eco round out of NaVi. Not holding on to any weapons, not holding on to any guns. They have to eco now, seeing as how pretty much the entire team is floating anywhere between 3,000 and 4,000. So I want to see the impact that Guardian is going to have once he has his AWP. And I think a lot of pressure is going to be on Guardian here to start getting those entry frags for NaVi to slow down Fnatic early on. Fnatic just going for all-out aggression straight up. Quad, JW leading the charge here. Right around the corner and gets dropped down to 6, and he's going to get caught by Zeus in the end. Great eagle shot there by Zeus.
Yeah, and actually Guardian's going to take down Ulfmeister, and there's another headshot. Zeus with the 1 deeg, and that's a pretty good eco round from NaVi. And look at where Edward is inside here. Once again, he's boosted himself up inside this bomb site. Molotov is not going to reach him. Probably going to get a little bit hot under that roof, but he's not going to go down, and he should be able to pick up at least one kill almost instantaneously.
Oh man, that is such a big... This is huge for Edward as well. Does Pronax even check this position? He doesn't! Surprise! They think that the Molotov would have cleared out that position. That's the last place they're going to check. They're never going to look up. And now they know that Edward can be up there. So if they ever go for that Molotov again, they're going to know that they have to check that position. That's Pronax noting that in his mind right now, being like, okay, never again. Never again does that happen.
Well, moving straight into the 8th round, we have finally got NaVi on the board here for Inferno. I'm not sure if it's not too late. I mean, if they can make a crazy comeback of their own and someone make this 9-6, that would be good, but JW has a different plan in mind, and it's going to be taking down Seized. But I think if Fnatic get more than 6 rounds on this first half, that's going to be too much to handle, basically. Good return from Guardian, and that might give them a chance.
Oh, Starix and Zeus both dropping scarily low here. On that B site, the defense is weak. Fnatic have certainly taken note. It comes down to a solid defense on the A site now as Edward has taken up his position on balcony. He's looking towards. JW's going to peek forward, take a shot and miss. JW decides to re-peek as well with 22 HP. That's playing with fire there, JW. But they're still in a 4-on-4 situation here. Fnatic facing off, but they still have 50 seconds on this clock.
They do have a chance. You're absolutely right. And I think your microphone sometimes sounds like it's stuttering a little bit. So I'm wondering if there's either some lag on your end or something else.
Or maybe I'm not holding down the push to talk button correctly as well.
No, it's not that. It sounds a little bit like Vendetta's used to when we were on the other mumble server. It sounds like it's...
Oh, robot.
Yeah, like roboting, briefly cutting out a little bit. It's a little bit weird.
We'll see if we can figure it out, guys. If we need to, we'll change servers.
Yeah, we'll see if we can figure it out, guys. In the meantime, it's a 4-on-4, 20 seconds left, and it's going to be a push for the A-bomb site. Edward holding inside, down in pit. Guardian's been so well zoned out, he can't really help Edward a lot, so Edward's going to have to do it alone, and he won't.
Oh, luckily for Na'Vi as well. Guardian in the pit finds a nice shot that brings it back to a 3-on-3, but the health difference here between both of these teams makes Na'Vi's life very difficult. They need to move in and find some frags quick, though, but Starx is going to get caught by Olafmeister over at Arch, and Zeus, as soon as he loses support, he has to do a double take, make sure that he isn't getting wrapped around on. Flusha in the back of the site will find Zeus. Guardian manages to return on Flusha, but Guardian is stuck in the pit, and there's no way he's getting out of here. Crims is up in the apartments, and this is the guarantee. Guardian runs right into Olafmeister, but even had Guardian stayed on that site, Crims up in apartments is going to be able to peek as soon as Guardian goes for that bomb. So an unwinnable situation for Guardian in the end, but luckily for Na'Vi, they had enough money left over because of that eco round win that they're able to get a buy-in here. Hmm. Otherwise, it's right back to pistols, and Fnatic just continues their rampage.
All right, let's try and move over to the other mumble server just for fun, right? See if that works better. Do you have the IP?
Yeah, let's do it.
All right. So sorry about that, guys. I'm not sure what the issue was, but there was definitely something going on. It might have been the mumble server, so hopefully it is. We've had this experience before, and we have like 2 or 3 different mumble servers that we work on. We've also tried Skype and Ventrilo and everything, but when you do broadcasting for like 12 hours a day, sometimes you just do run into weird server issues. So hopefully it's going to be just fine. Now we're moving into the 9th round, and Na'Vi, they get into the worst possible situation, winning a round and then losing the next one. So they are able to force it up this time, but if they start losing now, I think Fnatic are going to run away with this whole first half in a matter of seconds, basically. We shall see. Guardian with a good opening pick. A lot rides on this one round here. Flashbang goes through, and actually Pronax not going to be able to pick up the kill there in return. Flusha, though, will take down Seized. And welcome back, Simler. Does it sound better?
Anders.
Yes. Can you hear me right? I think maybe Simler can't hear me. All right. We're having interesting issues. I'm really sorry. There we go. Can you hear me right, Simler?
Yo.
All right. Until I can hear... Well, just have to figure this out when the round is done, unfortunately. I'm very sorry, guys. Obviously, technical issues, no fun at all. Crims and Olafmeister now 2-on-3 with 10 seconds left. They're going to go for the bomb plant. They're a man down. The bomb will be planted, and Seuss actually goes down. Instead of preventing the plant, he gets himself killed. Now, Guardian charging him with a knife out. Very careless play. It's going to be a 1-on-2 instead of a 2-on-3 for Edward, and he's going to be rushing in here with a lot of speed. Jumping about, trying to see if he can pick up the opening. He's getting shot in the back as well. And Fnatic are playing this very well. Hard for Edward to do anything about this. Olafmeister will go down. That still leaves Crims, who's just around the corner. Edward's going to fake it once, and he's going to go down to Crims. So there it is. All right, let me see if I can figure this out, guys. All right, there we go. Can you hear me, Simler?
There we go.
Ah.
Yes, I can. Can you hear me?
I can hear you just fine, yes.
Okay, don't give me a heart attack like that.
And you sound like there's no more stuttering going on, so I think we're cool for a moment, at least until this server also starts being weird.
Okay, well, we'll figure it out. We'll go as we see. I mean, that last round that just happened as we were sorting all this out was just hugely important. Fnatic have taken Na'Vi, basically, in a back-to-back scenario, and now Na'Vi are forced to eco. So what we talked about in the round before, thankfully Na'Vi had enough money to get another buy round in, but Fnatic go through that regardless and are now in position to take 9 rounds. 9 rounds on the T side of Inferno is a fantastic scoreline for Fnatic.
Yeah, and any kind of doubts or any kind of worries they might have had coming out of Mirage, I think they're washed away at this point. Fnatic are going to be feeling great and in prime form. They're going to be up a map in the Grand Finals, very, very likely. I mean, there's still a chance that NaVi can come back into it, but Fnatic right now, it's not even like NaVi are making a lot of mistakes at the moment. I just think NaVi are, so Fnatic are playing a really, really cool game of Counter-Strike.
Yeah, they really are. I mean, it's just thorough play. Seized and Starix, though, managed to find two frags here. Nicely done by them. But there's still three members living here for Fnatic, and it looks like Seized has managed to save that AWP, which is a great haul for him. If he can get out of here in one piece, do Fnatic let him get away? They really should be out hunting, and they are going to manage to get fairly close. Flushout, not sure if he spotted him out there, but Seized misses a shot, and that's not going to help things. Flushout does not let him escape. And that's a great kill there for Fnatic as well, making sure that Guardian is not going to get a free AWP in the next round.
Oh man, so that's unfortunate, because that would have been a kind of a nice save, especially if you consider how good Guardian is with that weapon. But right now, nobody, there's really nobody on NaVi who's sort of seriously standing out. I mean, Guardian has one more kill than Edward. But on the other team, it is definitely Crims who's waking up here, 12-0-3, and doing a lot of work for Fnatic.
No, ever since he's joined up with this new Fnatic lineup, he's been the point man, pretty much. He's really shown just consistent play, consistently topping the scoreboard, basically, for Fnatic. It's been excellent to watch. Pronax and Flush, I mean, they're basically, Fnatic are just romping right through NaVi right now, even though this is a buy round, even though NaVi put every buck they have into buying as much gear as possible, it's not helping them. Three frags for Fnatic in the blink of an eye. Starx gets caught at the bottom of mid by Flusha, and now it's just Seized alive at Arch, spots Olafmeister, but then gives his position away, and it's still a 1v3.
Yeah, and really hard to know what he can make of this situation. I think, you know, again, best case scenario is a bunch of exit frags, but actually winning it's going to be nearly impossible, and Flusha's already preparing for Seized trying to run away and save the rifle. He's already sort of trying to backstab him. Actually, he doesn't have a kit, so it's not even a problem. But if he had a kit and he had found Pronax, that would have been a little bit tricky, but that doesn't even happen.
Do they cross? No, okay, Flusha sees it. Flusha's got this. Surprise, surprise, Flusha's already here. He's one step ahead of you. Sees it coming from a mile away, and Seized is not able to hold on to that gun. And Navi's money is shattered right now. Again, Edward buys the Swag 7 because he's the only guy who is even above 3650. Seized has got some decent money, but the rest of them are all floating around $2,700. That's just not enough to put together a reasonable buy together here. And Fnatic are sitting on 10 rounds on the T side of Inferno. Again, this is just a fantastic play from Fnatic that they continue to chain rounds together versus Navi.
Yeah, it definitely is very impressive, and there's just no other way to put it. I mean, we did expect Fnatic to probably take Inferno and have a strong performance, but this is a little more than even, you know, what is Fnatic's sort of usual level on this map, and that's just, yeah, we're Grand Finals time. Now is where you want to step it up and play above your usual level, so that's really cool. 2-on-3 here, some headshots coming in from Seized and Guardian. Probably not going to be enough to make a difference in this eco round.
No, Seized. They are playing for the B side again. The bomb is here. Two members, Pronax and Flusha. And Olafmeister making sure that Guardian can't wrap around from behind. But Seized is alive on this site. Not sure if they've spotted him out quite yet, but there you go. Pronax, as soon as he sees him, Seized instantly give. Guardian does manage to pick up an AK, though, and put that to use on Olafmeister, but he's on the wrong site right now. And it seems like for him, he's just interested in backing off. Even if it is a 1v2, he's too far away right now. He'd waste too much time on the clock before he can even get in there and even just get the two kills that would allow him to defuse the bomb.
Yeah, it's such a tough situation at this point for NaVi. It's hard to find anything to get really excited about until they show us something, right? They gotta show us that they're back in the map, and I bet they're trying. I don't think NaVi have given up or anything like that, but you need that opening. You need one guy who goes insane and picks up, you know, four or five kills and then you try and get back from that position, and it hasn't happened yet.
They even hunt down Guardian. He can't save that AK. He doesn't go for the attempt, tries to save the rifle, and Pronax is merciless. Finds him in the end. Fnatic now 11 rounds, and this is Fnatic just basically making a statement after the insane comeback on Mirage. To manage that comeback, first of all, huge, but Fnatic are now just making a statement saying, doesn't matter which side of the map we're on, this is the level that we're playing at right now, and JW shuts down Guardian, Navi's main hope in coming back into this map. He's already gone in this round.
Edward waiting up in apartments here, gonna throw down a grenade, which will do some really good damage, actually. That's pretty impressive. That's 57 damage onto Olafmeister. That's actually a whole lot for one grenade, especially when it's an armored target. JW didn't even shoot.
Max.
I think JW just fired away the AWP that he threw up on the roof, making sure nobody from Na'Vi could pick it up if it ever came to it.
Wow. Every point right now, JW controls mid, flush at the top of banana controls that. Zeus tries to peek forward to get some kind of information, something that Na'Vi can work with, and flush it instantly shuts him down. Sure, Zeus sees that, hey, there's guys there from Fnatic, but there's not enough time for his teammates to even get into position. Star can't put anything down as far as a crossfire, or as far as a shot through the smoke even, from CT. And Edward is all the way on the other side of the site. But guess what? Olafmeister is there as well, and he's already hunting down those Na'Vi members.
This is, this is just a slaughter. Fnatic seeking revenge, and they're going to get it here on Inferno as well. It went to overtime on Mirage for the first map in the Grand Finals. This is the second map. Technically, if you want to be strict about it, it's the third map, but first map wasn't played. It was just Fnatic taking it because they came from the upper bracket. And right now, they're looking to take a 2-1 map lead, which would put them at just one map away from taking a victory. I mean, at this point, I don't know. I can't see any combination of... I can't see any way that Na'Vi can really get back into this.
No, I think that... Like, this is essentially like the wolf pack. That's what Fnatic is, you know? They're living up to that Scandinavian blood of theirs. Because they've thoroughly hamstrung Na'Vi. They've dissected them, basically. You could call Pronax a surgeon at this point, because they have just thoroughly dissected Na'Vi every single time. It's just a process that Fnatic are going through. You know, pick one guy off here, refrag there. Just every single time they seem to come out ahead. We're into a 2-on-2 now. But again, both members for Fnatic are gathered up together on this A site and moving very quick. Guardian has to land a stellar shot right away.
Yeah, and instead he's going to get forced back in the site, and Edward's too far away to help out. Good shot from Guardian, but it's still going to be a 1-on-1. And this is about the closest, I think this is the closest Na'Vi have been to actually taking a second round for quite a while.
It's a very close thing. Edward, there is no saving, there is no backing off. He doesn't have a kit either, so he doesn't have a whole lot of time to act. It's going to take him 10 seconds to defuse that bomb. And Pronax is in the ideal situation. Oh, he is actually changing it up completely. He's going to try and find a different angle to keep eyes on this bomb, because if he was coming in from short, it wouldn't be ideal to stop Edward from defusing. But if he comes in from library, Edward already sees it coming. This is perfect. Edward, your golden opportunity, your time to shine, make it happen. And he doesn't. He turns away. He turns away from Pronax.
Oh, Pronax playing it really, really well. I'm not sure he knew that Edward was coming in from that angle, but he made a choice and stuck with it. Just decided, I'm gonna take this gamble, and it worked out. 13-1. Just, steamrolling Na'Vi right now. That's all we can say.
That was the closest, but then it's the pack leader. Of course, it's the pack leader that ends it, right? No, Zeus is just going to town right now out of frustration. JW going again for that boiler rush. Zeus is going to be right behind him. He has to be, but they hear him. Zeus not going to get the double spray down. Seized does take a man down at banana, and that's a bomb dropped as well. Now Na'Vi have a shred of control in this round. They just have to maintain the man advantage that they've got.
Yeah, there's a good chance they can finish this 2-2-13, which would be, I guess, marginally better than 14-1, but not really. C's spotting one guy there, and he's going to take him down, and Crims is also going to get almost caught here. 2-on-3 with Crims on 6 points of health, and with Na'Vi controlling the bomb, they should be able to do this.
Oh, they should. C's is alive still. Edward catches Olafmeister, who is on a flank mission. Now it's just going to be Crims with 6 points of health, but Crims has all day. He can sit here as long as he wants and just wait to see if anybody's going to peek out and give him the opportunity to do more damage. I mean, it's the last round. There's no saving. There's no anything here. It just comes down to when Crims decides to move forward Guardian with the position to take advantage of it in the end. 13-2, the final score. Fnatic making one monster statement that their T side essentially is something to be feared.
Yeah, I mean, the thing is, we saw so many situations from Na'Vi that has worked previously in this finals for them, which is, you know, them trying to flash their way out onto banana or go for a pick in the middle, and it just seemed like every single time they tried anything, Fnatic got the return frag, and you can get into that position. I mean, that's what we sometimes talk about with playing with confidence and also having just the momentum on your side. Eventually, Fnatic, everything they did just worked out perfectly for them. And that's really scary. I mean, we could be skipping Inferno almost entirely and just moving straight to train is what it seems like.
Yeah, I'm really impressed with Crims' play. His individual play has just been so good. I mean, we say it time and time again, but ever since Olafmeister and Crims have joined up, again, Olafmeister finding himself at the bottom of the scoreboard here, which really is kind of odd considering he's the most versatile player on the team. But Crims has been put into a position where he is going to be taking those shots to get the frags, and he hasn't disappointed Fnatic ever since he's joined up. Like, he is consistently at the top of the board, getting the kills that he needs to, and giving Fnatic the options, giving Pronax basically the means to execute the plans that he has in mind.
Yeah.
And I mean, the other thing here to remind ourselves, just before we get too excited, is that this is not like on Mirage, where we could say, okay, now it's Fnatic's turn to be on, you know, on the more favorite side, or Na'Vi's turn in this case. Playing on the Terry side of Inferno is a lot more difficult than it is playing the CT side. So it's not like Na'Vi now have the upper hand and can make like a Mirage-style comeback that Fnatic almost did. I think this is highly unlikely. Way, I would say, like twice or three times as difficult as it was on Mirage for Fnatic.
Na'Vi aren't even wasting any time right now. They go full Kevlar. They're going for the straight-up fight. Fnatic get caught out in the open, though, and it's a complete and utter slaughter.
Okay. They all met in the middle, and it's going to be a flawless streak from Na'Vi. So, in terms of pistol rounds, that was great.
That was something. That was... I don't even know what that was. That was Fnatic basically saying, okay, we're going to take this fight and end it right here. And then Na'Vi landed all the shots and Fnatic didn't. And Na'Vi had Kevlar as well. So basically, Fnatic needed to land 4 headshots instantly, and they just didn't do it. Because if you're using a USPS, even a P2K, you feel like you're shooting spitballs if the target is wearing Kevlar. So... Well, there you go. Fnatic still have quite a lot of room to work with, though, so they are definitely not feeling too pressured here. Hell, Na'Vi have to survive the eco round out of Fnatic now before they can start giving themselves a pat on the back.
And if they go for B, that's certainly not going to be too easy, actually. Fnatic going to go and meet them outside Banana, and Pronax picking up a kill, and he will get a second one. Oh, that 5-7, how well it works. Starix is going to be alone. He walks into a grenade and shoots through himself, and it's going to be a 1-on-3 for him here, so Fnatic... They might not even give Na'Vi the chance to do this. Flusher will finish it off. But I think that was Pronax with the 5-7. He almost killed 3 people.
Pronax is the 5-7 champion. He did it at Gamescom as well, where his entire team is buying CZs. No, Pronax, he sticks to the 5-7. And that's why he manages to mow down 2 guys and nearly take a third with him. The 5-7 is a lethal pistol. It's like 96% armor penetration. So if you are getting that close to a target, you're going to do a lot of damage. Pronax was coming through huge, and now Fnatic are on the brink. Fnatic, 14 rounds, they're 1 round away from at least getting overtime.
Yeah, and Na'Vi don't really have money. They're going to force it up anyway here, which can't really blame them for. I mean, nobody wants to fight for 12 rounds or 13 rounds of overtime, so might as well do something. But it's not going to be possible, I think.
It's going to be very tough. Starix is knifing Zeus point blank. Oh, great spray onto JW with the Deagle. And now Flusher trying to get the refrag, but he's going to be just a little bit too late. Decides not to run in. And does Zeus decide to try and pass this gun off to Seize? No, he's going to give it over to Guardian, and that's really smart. Just make sure that the guys who have the full HP and the Kevlar get those rifles, because they're going to be able to have the best opportunities to put those rifles to use.
Look at Pronex. Is the timing going to be good enough here? He's going to find one person, and that's great. They do lose a guy in Archway in the meantime. Krims is going to try and take over here, and... Not a bad person to have covering. In fact, they're not even going to fight him any longer. Pronax is going to come out of boiler room and takes down Seize. The bomb will go down, but Fnatic have a 1-man advantage. They have Molotovs as well, and that was a 2-on-2.
Yeah, Crimson Olaf. I mean, Crimson Olaf working together now. In short, they're going to try and push through. It's going to be Guardian holding in pit right now, and he's got the control. So long as he's alive, Fnatic can't get up onto this site, changing up his position as well. But Krims instantly spots him out, and it's all going to be down to Zeus. No HP left on Zeus. Fnatic, with the kit, will have plenty of time for the defuse. And everything goes their way in the end here.
Yeah, just a solid retake coming in here from Fnatic. Even losing Pronex after he picked up a triple is... But there was just fine. I think they had that on lockdown. It's just so little HP left for Na'Vi. 15-3! And obviously Na'Vi forcing up whatever they can here to try and see if they can get back in and at least get a slightly better score and maybe some confidence back.
Well, now they have to pull a Fnatic. Now they have to go on the mission to get many rounds on the board and potentially, you know, just go with another, like a sick counter comeback, right? Take it to overtime. Can you imagine how sick that would be, Anders?
Yeah, well, it would be sick, but I really can't believe in it. I think this
Oh, ye of little faith.
Yeah, no, I mean, as much as I love Na'Vi, and I think they're great players and everything, and, well...
Whoa!
Okay, Cease. Well done.
that was pretty cool. Remax, he comes back and takes out StarX, but that was just a really cool shot from Cease. Oh, I'm giddy now. I'm happy. I'm grinning. That was a really nice shot. And Seized, does he get it on Pronax? Pronax? No scope! What's up? Seized laying waste. It's the Shangair scout. It stayed in Europe when Shangair's went back to NA. He handed it off to Seized with his blessing.
Oh, important shot coming in there from Olofmeister to take down Seized. Now it is back in a 3-on-3. And Flush is still holding inside here. Crims is coming over as well, so this is actually going to be a pretty hard take for Na'Vi. Even though they had the advantage earlier here, Crims going to take down the bomb and going to pick up a second one. Crims finishes the game in 19 rounds with 22 kills and only 9 deaths. Very impressive performance from him. Nicely done by Crims. And, well, the rest of Fnatic, I mean, they all just played really well. 16-3 victory. That's a bit of a message, I think.
Yeah, that is Fnatic clearly warmed up. And that is going to be Na'Vi rocked. So I think Na'Vi are definitely going to need quite a bit of a breather. They're going to try and stretch the break, I think, to really just sit down and try and go over, find themselves again, because they desperately need to dig deep right now and find a way to deal with Fnatic, because this is basically Fnatic, the start that they could have had on Mirage if they were warmed up, they've had on Inferno. So this is the clear statement to Na'Vi saying, well, okay, you know, the first map, it was a bit bumpy, but this is how the rest of the show is going to go unless you guys wake up and come at us toe-to-toe here. So... Fantastic, fantastic finals so far. 2-1 for Fnatic.